Chrysler, a car brand established in 1925, has left an unforgettable mark on popular culture through its appearances in iconic media such as The Fast and the Furious, Stephen King's Christine, and The Dukes of Hazzard. The Valiant Chrysler, an Australian branch active from 1962 to 1981, holds a special place in the hearts of many Australians. Reflecting on the brand's history and their youth, passionate Chrysler enthusiasts gather annually at Chrysler's on the Murray in Albury-Wodonga. This event provides an opportunity for fellow Chrysler lovers to connect.
Passionate comes to mind. Enjoying the ride. It's not just that going being at a car show, but actually going to a car show, to and from, you know, and enjoying the same sort of interests as other Chrysler enthusiasts.
Growing up, my father's prized possession was his Mercury Silver RT-E38 Valiant Charger. Australia's muscle car of the 70s. The roaring engine and the scorching vinyl seats were etched into my memories. Dad was often found in the shed, surrounded by cars, smelling like sweat and petroleum, a smell that now feels like home. As I grew older, my interest faded and I attended car shows only out of obligation. I'm still not really coming for the cars. This time I'm here for the people. It was time for the fresh open road and the Valiant Charger's fumes filled the air. The car's presence demanded attention on the road. While cruising through the Victorian high country, over Mount Hotham, the wind icy and the hills sprawling, 80s hits played, evoking memories and stories from my dad's time as a police officer. Driving further into the countryside, the car's engine began to sputter. We pulled into Yakandanda, where concern grew. The local mechanics were hesitant to help, but in Wodonga, they finally agreed. It was fascinating to witness the admiration for one another among car enthusiasts. The Charger was a free ticket into a weld shop, where my dad himself welded a new piece of metal onto the cracked exhaust extractor. The spirit of the Chrysler community was evident. How is it that a car company from the 1900s still holds such a grip on people today? That was the question I wanted to explore. The first day of Chrysler's on the Murray offered organized track racing, where my dad's car received admiration I had never truly appreciated before.
Is it real?
Yeah.
Wow. I'll be too scared to race it.
Well, I'm almost too scared.
In any world, you know that means something. The second day, bathed in the scorching Australian sun, presented a field of old cars lined up in perfect rows. It felt as if I was stepping into a display case, surrounded by vibrant colours and various models. These cars were more than just machines. They represented Australian history and embodied the spirit of the 80s. I had the chance to speak with Bill Papanicolaou, founder of Valiant Infobase, who collects data on Valiants across Australia to trace their history.
Well, I mean, what I do is, my analogy is I do a family tree for cars. I'm an enthusiast just like everybody else. I don't profess to be a whiz-bang thinger, but I know about manipulating data and spitting it out in simple terms for people.
This led me to the question that had been asked yesterday. What does it mean if a car is real? Why wouldn't it be?
Well, these cars rust. If you don't look after them, they'll rust. And most Valiants, I mean, you're talking, you know, 50-year-old cars plus. So there are certain areas of a car that rusts, and sometimes a car is just beyond repair.
My dad often refers to himself as a Tarvo, or a tight-ass Valiant owner, buying parts and equipment from the cheapest parts of the internet. Are all Chrysler enthusiasts the same?
Well, Tavos have obviously, I can go on with this one, but no, there's quite a few of them that do have a tight pocket. But in general, you know, they're just passionate. And I mean, look, we're not driving Ferraris. We're not super, super rich, you know, so, you know, we do our best with what we have with the cars we drive.
I also had the opportunity to speak with Andrew about his experience with Chargers.
I've owned 78 Chargers since 1983, all up. But that includes wrecks, good road cars, cars I put in Speedway. That includes all of them. My red Kelpie comes everywhere. I go to a lot of interstate car shows and he comes everywhere with me, whether it's down to the local shops, do some shopping, or car shows, interstate, thousands of kilometres. He's no trouble whatsoever. He loves the car, he loves the people, and he's 12 and a half now, but, you know, the long trips might be getting too much for him soon, but at the moment, he's still coping, so he's coming with me.
The conversations revealed that the cars were more than transportation. They defined character and forged connections. The day ended with drag racing. As the cars roared down the street throughout the night, the people mingled. Strangers became friends, and friends became brothers.